Tom Allen, James Acaster, Judy Love and Asim Chowdhury. Now, we do have a whole stack of guests at our socially distanced bar over here. They will be joining us throughout the night. Horns, would you like to introduce them, please?
Of course.
Here we go. I'm James Acaster. There you go, all the guests.
James, are you a bit of a party animal at New Year's Eve?
Big time, man. Normally, me and some pals just rent out. Not a lot of people know you can hire this out, but we just hire Big Ben for the evening. And we just party in there. A bit, well, not big, yeah, obviously Big Ben's the bell. The clock's not called. The clock is called, not a lot of people know. The clock is called Tickety Ted, the time telling bitch.
Did you guys follow the US election? Were you excited by it? James, were you into it?
Yeah, man, me and my mates rigged it. Big time. We wanted to ensure the right people won. We didn't care. We knew that everyone would just think Trump was off his rocker claiming it was rigged.
Yeah.
So that has played into our hands. It's worked out very well. Even saying this, everyone thinks I'm a comic, it's going to be made up, so it doesn't matter.
I hope you did sanitise that chair after I sat in it.
Yes, absolutely.
Nothing to do with coronavirus.
All right, so, James, what were your highlights of the year?
Oh, I became chess grandmaster this year.
Woo! That's
good. That was good. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I learned in the orphanage that I went to, and I learned there was an old man in the cellar, and I used to go and have lessons from him in the cellar, and he taught me how to do chess.
Yeah.
And then my alcoholic mother took me around the world and became really good at it, and then I beat the kid from Love Actually. I think. I haven't seen all of it. I think that's what happened.
Lorraine?
Generally, I think the world has got better.
Yeah.
I think it has. I think people have got kinder, and that's a good thing.
I agree.
Or am I just pretending?
No, do you know what?
And making the world the way that I want it to be.
Yes, you are pretending.
Have you seen the wee penguins in South Africa?
No.
Well, they live on the beach, and now they got fed up with the beach, and they're going into just waddling around, you know, looking in the shop windows and having a really nice time and holding hands.
Lorraine, are you living on a different planet?
I was just going to say, I want to live in Lorraine's world.
I'm trying to work out how I'm going to link from that to Heroes of the Year. Let's go, Heroes of the Year. Lorraine.
I think, stay with me on this one. Piers Morgan.
Go fuck yourself.
Stay with me. I understand. I appreciate the sentiment. And don't look at me like that. I did say stay with me, love.
Okay.
I did.
Go right. On.
Because do you remember when things had turned with him when Boris Johnson hid in a fridge rather than be interviewed by Piers Morgan?
Yes.
None of the cabinet ministers would come on the telly because they were too scared.
Yep.
And they all phoned up and went, hi, do you remember us? Can we come back on the telly? And then they all came back on the telly. And actually, it would have been better if they didn't. Because I don't know about you, but I would much rather talk to H from Steps than Pretty Patel. H from Steps, Pretty Patel, H from Steps, H from Steps.
You almost won James back over there.
James, are you? No. Okay.
No,
you know, no, it's fine. No,
you
no,
don't get to stop being a villain for 2 seconds and now you're a hero. Well, you watched Superman or something, and all the way through Lex Luthor's killing everyone, and at one point he's nice to an old lady, and everyone goes, well, then, let's screw you, Superman. You're the
okay.
Wow, he's such a good guy.
I'll tell you what, nothing sums up 2020 more than the nation's sweetheart being told at the end of it to go fuck yourself.
It's fine, I can take it.
Look,
it's
I'm not proud of it. I'm not proud of it,
no,
Lorraine.
It's okay.
I apologise.
Oh my gosh.
I just can't hear that man get defended, especially by you.
I know.
The danger with you saying it is people will go with it and go, oh, yeah, Lorraine likes penguins, so Piers Morgan must be all right. And then we're in trouble. It would be OK if anyone else here said it.
OK.
But when you said it, I was like, everyone's going to go along with that now. And that's what scares me.
Yeah,
and now I'm not even sure if I like penguins anymore.
Now, one of our favourite heroes of the year was a guy called Speedo Mick, who walked from one end of the country to the other in his Speedos for charity. Please welcome Speedo Mick!
Well, I could walk 500 miles and I would walk 500 more just to be the man who walked 1,000 miles to fall down at your door.
I mean, we haven't seen you since the beginning of the year. How did your year pan out?
Well, absolutely terrible, of course. You know what I mean? Yeah. It's been a difficult year for everyone. And I've just totally lost the plot.
I did not know where to look.
Well, listen, everybody looks at the Nether Regions.
Must have been weird for you, because you were doing interviews with big Hollywood stars.
I was at home. You know, I was in my tracksuit and my slippers, and I was talking to Mr. George Clooney. So I think it's the way ahead.
Yeah.
Lorraine, you know you're talking right now.
Yes.
I don't know what it is, but I have this urge, because I'm sitting in this chair, to tell you to shut the fuck up. And I blame James for that. What have you done, James? This is Lorraine Kelly.
James.
And I'm looking at you and I want to say shut the fuck up, even though I love you.
But it's okay.
Let's look at some of the things we've missed this year. The big one, of course, for us being the Paralympics. What else have we missed? James?
Eating pangolin. I used to eat pangolin. God. I missed the pangolin cookouts.
Hello, welcome back to the last leg of the year. It's that time of the show when I face my inevitable future as a daytime quiz show host. It's our last leg pub quiz. Now, on Adam's team, we have Tom Allen, Clara Amfo, and go fuck yourself, Lorraine Kelly. I hope they haven't tuned in halfway through. On Alex's team, Asim Chowdhury, Judy Love, and go fuck yourself, James A. The first question is for Adam's team. I took this photo of an audience member at the last leg this year. But why did I take it? Was it? C, he looked and was dressed exactly like James Acaster. D, it was Asim Chowdhury, who is such a big fan of the show, he applied for tickets through the normal audience channels.
The fact that James said, I know, suggests he was dressed as James.
I think...
I don't think James would remember if he was just a big fan of Taskmaster.
Right, you're going to go with C. He looked exactly like James Acaster?
I think so.
Let's have a look at the photo.
Yes! Yes!
He looks exactly like James Acaster. Yes! 1 point.
Well done, Tom.
Well done. Hey, James, obviously, you were the answer to the question.
Yes.
We've promoted Tom's book. Have you got anything you'd like to promote this year?
Yeah. Peace and love.
TV show next year, James?
Oh, yeah, Josh Whittaker and myself host the show. It's called Hypothetical. It's coming today. We've got many amazing guests, including Judy Love and Tom Allen. It's very exciting.
Here's a clip. Do you want to play Josh?
Oh, with pleasure. There we go. Yeah.
Aww. Uh-huh. I hate your cat.
Shoes on your knees.
Oh, yeah. What's that?
Huh?
What's that?
Oh, you have not seen yourself, mate. Oh, yeah. Here he comes, the waddler. That's what we say.
Right.
Josh Waddle come.
Yeah. 10 p.m. day, February, 10 points for James Acaster. There we go. Which of these isn't a real Lorraine Kelly credit on her IMDb page? D, Lorraine Kelly on gangs. Alex, what are you thinking?
I really want Lorraine Kelly on gangs to be a real show.
I think she'd be great. I think she'd be fantastic.
I think she could calm down some of those gangs.
Yeah.
Be a bit like Danny Dyer, wouldn't you? It's all fucking kicking off here.
She would say in a Lorraine way, wouldn't she?
Lorraine would say, really, all these gangs are quite nice.
What's your answer?
The answer is Lorraine Kelly on gangs. Wouldn't it look so stupid that we didn't go for that?
Yeah,
let's go Lorraine Kelly on gangs.
Correct answer, one word. How am I linked to Clara Amfo? Oh. A, her and my wife used to work in rival skate shops. C, she gave the wrong answers to my wife when they were doing maths GCSE. Or D, she recently turned up at my house having bought my wife's old Game Boy on eBay.
I know Josh's wife, so does Brooker, although he's keeping quiet about it for some reason. I don't know if she would sell a Game Boy. I feel like it's the GCSE one, I'm just going to say that.
Alex.
I'm going to go with James.
Yeah.
The answer is Clara.
We both used to work in rival skate shops.
Oh. Okay, the next round is for Adam's team.
Okay. Oh, yep. Good, good. I'm looking forward
to it. And it is based on Judy Love, and it is called Judy Love or Not Love. Your team is going to see a number of photos of Judy Love with a heart covering her face. All you need to do is tell me, is she happy or not? There we go. Oh. Big news for Big Pants, but are you pleased? Judy Love or Judy Not Love?
I'm going to say Judy Not Love.
Is it Judy Love or Judy Not Love? It's Judy Not Love! The next round is based on Mr. Tom Allen. Oh. It's called Pocket Square or Weatherspoon's Carpet. Is this a Pocket Square or a Weatherspoon's Carpet?
Oh. That's I carpet. Thought you couldn't top Judy Love or Judy Not Love. This is. Yeah, I think that looks like a Weatherspoon's carpet.
Yeah, that looks like it's been like trodden in for people who voted for Brexit.
Yeah.
You think it's Weatherspoon's?
Yeah.
Let's reveal it. It is. It's the William Henry in Weymouth.
Well done.
The final Pocket Square or Weatherspoon's carpet.
That's gotta be.
That's gotta be.
You're going Pocket Square?
Yeah.
Tom?
Yeah.
It's the Pocket Square I'm wearing tonight, yeah. Everybody!
Yes, it's from Liberty!
We thought we'd create our own Paralympic challenge live in the studio for Alex to take part in. Yeah. Fencing, take on Acaster, who is in peak physical condition right now.
I'm doing this for you, Lorraine. Go fuck yourself, Acaster!
Amazing, it's just like the real thing. All right, swimming, swimming next. Very quickly, resolutions for 2021. And James?
I'm going to mess up more. And then I can make some really good New Year's resolutions for the following year.
Would you like to see footage of James Acaster on my stag do attempting to jump a fence?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yes.
Come on, Fancy!
Come on, Fancy!
Oh, Fancy!
Okay.